things look quiet enough here. Come on, there's my uncle. Uncle Halvar, hello.
Hadvar? What are you doing here? Are you on leave from shores, bones? What happened to you, boy? Are you in some kind of trouble?
Keep your voice down. I'm fine, but we should go inside to talk.
What's going on? And who's this?
He's a friend. Saved my life, in fact. Come on, I'll explain everything, but we need to go inside.
Okay, okay, come inside then. Sigrid will get you something to eat, and you can tell me all about it.
A dragon! I saw a dragon!
What? What is it now, Mother?
It was as big as the mountain and black as night. It flew right over the barrel.
Dragons now, is it? Please, Mother. If you keep on like this, everyone in town will think you're crazy. And I've got better things to do than listen to more of your fantasies.
Sigrid, we have company.
Hadvar, we've been so worried about you. Come, you two must be hungry. Sit down and I'll get you something to eat.
Now then, boy, what's the big mystery? What are you doing here looking like you lost an argument with a cave bear?
I don't know where to stop. You know I was assigned to General Tullius' guard. We were stopped in Helgen when we were attacked by a dragon.
A dragon? That's ridiculous. You aren't drunk, are you, boy?
Husband, let him tell his story.
Not much more to tell. This dragon flew over and just wrecked the whole place. Mass confusion. I don't know if anyone else got out alive. I doubt I'd made it out myself if not for my friend here. I need to get back to Solitude and let them know what's happened. I thought you could help us out. Food, supplies, a place to stay.
Of course. Any friend of Hadvar's is a friend of mine. I'm glad to help however I can. Like I said, I'm glad to help in any way I can. But I need your help. We need your help. Jarl needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word to Jarl Balgruuf in Whiterun to send whatever soldiers he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt. Jarl Balgruuf? He rules Whiterun Hold. A good man. Perhaps a bit overcautious, but these are dangerous times. So far, he's managed to stay out of the war. I'm afraid it can't last, though. I don't think he likes either Ulfric or Elisif much. Who can blame him? But I've no doubt he'll prove loyal to the Empire in the end. He's no traitor. Of course. Skyrim has always been part of the Empire. That doesn't mean I support everything the Empire's been doing lately. But Nords have never been fair-weather friends. Cross the river and then head north. You'll see it just past the falls. When you get to Whiterun, just keep going up. When you get to the top of the hill, you're at Dragon's Reach, the Jarl's Palace. Ah, I forget you're new to Skyrim. Jarl Elisif, I should say. Although only because she was married to Jarl Torig when he was murdered. Ulfric murdered Torig, you know. Walked right into his palace in Solitude and killed him. Shouted him to death, if you believe the stories. That's what started this whole war. The Empire couldn't ignore that. Once the Jarls start killing each other, we're back to the bad old days. Gerder's family first settled here as woodcutters, a few generations ago. She and Hod run the mill. I make a decent living sharpening axes and fixing the sawmill. People are rightly stirred up about the damn Thalmor being allowed to roam around arresting people, just for worshipping Talos. But was it worth tearing Skyrim apart and maybe destroying the Empire? No. Ulfric will have a lot to answer for in the end. Nords have always supported the Empire, and the Empire has always been good for Skyrim. I see no harm in it, if you have the skill. The grindstone will improve your weapons. Use the table to improve your armor. If you've got the raw materials, you can use the forge to make something new. Like I said, I'm glad to help in any way I can. Help yourself to whatever you need, within reason. It's from that treaty that ended the Great War, remember? When the Emperor was forced by the Thalmor to outlaw Talos worship. We didn't pay much attention to it when I was a boy. Everyone still had their little shrine to Talos. But then, Ulfric and his Sons of Skyrim started agitating about it. And sure enough, the Emperor had to crack down. Dragging people off in the middle of the night. One of the main causes of this war, if you ask me.
Mm-hmm. Hadvar, did you really see a dragon? What did it look like? Did it have big teeth?
Well, I'd better get back to work. You two make yourselves at home.
It's nice to be back in a friendly spot, huh? Listen, I'm going to lay up here for a while. You can make your own way to Solitude from here. I'd recommend heading to Whiterun, just down the road from here. From there you can take a carriage to Solitude. Of course. I know today wasn't the best introduction to the Legion, but I hope you'll give us another chance. The Legion could really use someone like you, especially now. And if the rebels have themselves a dragon, General Tullius is the only one who can stop them. No, not yet. After all, a dragon, something out of old tales and legends, no one could have expected that. But you can bet he'll be trying to figure it out. This could shift the whole balance of the war. If you want to help stop that dragon, your best bet is to go to Solitude and join up with the Legion. Sure, I understand. It's not easy to go from being executed by the Legion one day to joining up the next. But I think you'll see that the Legion is Skyrim's only hope for real peace right now. I know you'll make the right choice in the end.
I trust you're not planning any trouble. What can I do for you, friend?
Keep your guard up. Just head north, you can't miss it. It's the capital of Whiterun Hold, the biggest and the best of the 9 holds of Skyrim. But don't take my word for it. So did I. If the damn Stormcloak somehow found one, or woke it up, the war might be about to take an ugly turn. Hard to believe it was just a coincidence that the first dragon anyone's seen for centuries attacks just as Ulfric was about to be executed. Well, you didn't know? That was Ulfric Stormcloak and his top lieutenants. Right, the leader of the Stormcloaks. They claim to be fighting for Skyrim's freedom, but the war is really all about Ulfric wanting to be High King of Skyrim. You haven't heard of the civil war in Skyrim? I guess down in Cyrodiil, people have other things to worry about. It's pretty simple. Ulfric founded the Stormcloaks years ago, as a sort of private army to advance his ambitions. He's always used the ban on the worship of Talos to stir people up against the Empire. He never succeeded in getting much support, so a few months ago he murdered the High King. That got the Empire's attention. A masterstroke by General Tullius. He's only been in charge here for a few months, but he's turned things around for the Empire. We've been trying to catch Ulfric since the war started, but he always seemed to slip through our fingers, like he knew we were coming. This time, the General turned the tables on him. Ulfric rode right into our ambush with only a few bodyguards. He surrendered pretty meekly too. So much for his death or glory reputation. I thought we were taking Ulfric back to Cyrodiil, but I guess the General changed his mind. You know the rest. I guess that wasn't such a big deal elsewhere in the Empire, but here it's caused a lot of resentment. Native son and all that. Even I'll admit it hasn't been the Empire's finest hour. But it wasn't like the Emperor had any choice, did he? If he hadn't signed the peace treaty with the Thalmor, they would have destroyed the Empire. Then where would Skyrim be? That's the part that Ulfric's supporters always conveniently forget about. Unless the Empire stands together, the Thalmor will destroy us all. General Tullius has his headquarters in Castle Dower, in the city of Solitude, northwest of here. You'll want to talk to Legate Ricca. She deals with the new recruits. I'll be sure to put in a good word for you if I get back to Solitude first. Be careful on the way to Solitude. Damn Stormcloaks could be anywhere. What the Rebels like to forget is that the Empire is what's keeping the Dominion out of Skyrim. Stay sharp.
Make yourself at home.
I'm spoken for, you know, so don't get any ideas.
I just hope the war doesn't come to Riverwood. There's enough trouble in the world without those Stormcloaks stirring up more. Just follow the road north. When you get to Huntingbrew Meadery, turn left and the road will take you to the city gates. It's not far. We used to go to the market there every month or so until the roads got so dangerous with the war and all. Until next time.
Papa says I'm too friendly with strangers. But you seem all right. My
father's
Alfred, the blacksmith.
Take what you need, my friend.
I need a
within reason, of course.
someday, I'm going to forge my own sword. Papa says I'm not ready for weapons, so I make lots of horseshoes and hobbles.
Keep an eye out for trouble. It's only a matter of time.
Face, and a right ugly one at that. No offense. Got business here in Riverwood, eh? There are worse villages. At least the damned war hasn't gotten here yet. We work hard, try to do right by our families. Got my axe, my wife Gerder, and my boy Frodnar. That's all I need. Cutting's my trade. Best log splitter from here to Rift.
Orgnar. Orgnar, are you listening?
Hard not to.
The ale is going bad. We need to get a new batch. Did you hear me?
Yep, ale's going bad.
I guess you don't have potatoes in your ears after all. Just make sure we get a fresh batch in soon.
We got rooms and food. Drink, too. I cook. Ain't much else to tell. There have been whispers. A boy up in Windhelm, name of Aventus Aretino, been trying to contact the Dark Brotherhood. Long as you clean up, you know how to use it, right? Mix a couple of ingredients together, see what happens. A little wheat and blisterwort makes a healing potion, if you didn't know. We have plenty of ingredients for sale, too. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
The killer of kings. On the day of your death, we will drink and we'll sing.
Lucan at the Riverwood trader had his store broken into the other night. Oddly enough, barely anything's been stolen. Looking to blow yourself up? I hear that's what magic does to you. There's a college in Winterhold that teaches magic, unless that blew up too. Be a lot safer just to have the Jarl's wizard teach you a thing or two. Let's sate that appetite, hmm? Have you seen that shrine of Azura? They say the Dark Elves built it after they fled from Morrowind. Sight to see. Mm-hmm.
I'm the innkeeper. It's my business to keep track of strangers. They say a dragon attacked Helgen. Sounds like hogwash to me.
Give me a mug.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Until next time.
Take what you need, my friend. Within reason, of course.
Hmm? Got any ale or mead? Yeah.
All right, then.
This is a local favorite, and one of the first songs I ever learned. Ragnar the Red. Oh, there once was a hero named Ragnar the Red, who came riding to Whiterun from old Rorik's stead. And the braggart did swagger and brandish his blade, as he told of bold battles and gold he had made. But then he went quiet, did Ragnar the Red, when he met the shield maiden Matilda, who said, "Oh, you talk and you lie and you drink all our mead. Now I think it's high time that you lie down and bleed." And so then came clashing and slashing of steel, as the brave lass Matilda charged in full of zeal. And the braggart named Ragnar was boastful no more, when his ugly red head rolled around on the floor.
Thank you. my favorite drinking buddy. Let's get some mead.
Lucan yelling the other day, good dog.
Did you hear? The Riverwood trader was robbed. Poor Lucan must be torn to pieces over it. By shore, what do you want?
What you need, my friend. Within reason, of course. You need to leave. Got business here in Riverwood, eh? There are worse villages. At least the damned war hasn't gotten yet.
It's my boy. You need to listen to him. He sings at the inn most every night.
Did I see you talking to Sven? Maybe not. Maybe... never mind. But I would stay away from him if I were you. I'll show you what I know.
He's a bard, so he says. Occasionally, he finds time to do his job here at the mill. Thinks his ballads and sonnets are going to convince Camilla Valerius to marry him. As if she would say yes. An intelligent, beautiful woman like her wouldn't fall for that nonsense. I hope. I've been thinking. Maybe Camilla needs a little help seeing Sven for what he is. Could you give her this letter and say it's from Sven? I think I've matched that Nord's lack of cleverness perfectly. Farewell.
We work hard, try to do right by our families.
You're new around here, so I'll go.
Feindahl thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep telling him. Truly? So maybe my mother isn't crazy after all. You had best tell the Jarl in Whiterun. He needs to know about this. Lucan's got a little bit of everything at the Riverwood Trader. If you need weapons or armor, see Alvor, the blacksmith. At the Bard's College in Solitude, they train bards and scalds like myself. If you go there, talk to Viarmo. He's the headmaster. Sure. What can I do for you? All right, then.
Get me mad, and I'll prank you. And not a little, a lot.
Thank you.
by shore. What do you want?
Well, one of us has to do something.
I said no. No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Well, what are you going to do then, huh? Let's hear it.
We are done talking about this. Oh, a customer. Sorry you had to hear that. Well, I don't know what you overheard, but the Riverwood Trader is still open. Feel free to shop. We did have a bit of a break-in, but we still have plenty to sell. Robbers were only after one thing. An ornament, solid gold in the shape of a dragon's claw. You could? I've got some coin coming in from my last shipment. It's yours if you bring my claw back. Now, if you're going to get those thieves, you should head to Bleak Falls Barrow, northeast of town. Yes. So now you don't have to go, do you?
Oh, really? Well, I think your new helper here needs a guide.
By the eight, fine. But only to the edge of town.
This way. I'd better get going. Through town and across the bridge to get to Bleak Falls Barrow. You can see it from here, though. The mountain just over the buildings. Those thieves must be mad hiding out there. Those old filled with nothing but traps, trolls, and who knows what else.
Stupid dog.
This way. I'd better get going. I wonder why they only stole Lucan's golden claw. I mean, we have plenty of things in the shop that are worth just as much coin. Lucan found the claw about a year after he opened the door. He never quite explained where he got it. He's a tricky one. This is the bridge out of town. The path up the mountain to the northwest leads to Bleak Falls Barrow. I guess I should get back to my brother. He'll throw a fit if I take too long. Such a child. Mara bless you for agreeing to help us. Well, it's a winding road up the mountain just ahead. You'll know you're in the right place once you spot the old watchtower. Once you get to the tower, head north. Bleak Falls Barrow should be just around the corner further up. Another poem, I bet. He does know how to make a girl blush. What's this? If that oaf thinks all I'm going to do is stay in that filthy house of his and clean, I'll... You can tell Sven that he already has a mother. I'm not speaking to him anymore. Good luck. Lucan and I will be waiting for you back in the shop.
New to Riverwood? If you're looking for work, go see Hod at the mill.
Tell me as soon as you've given Camilla the letter.
I appreciate your help. Please, take this. Some gold I've saved up from working at the mill. Lead the way. I've got your back. What do you want me to carry? What do you want me to carry? I'll show you what I know. Lead on.
Mara bless you for agreeing to help us.
Good dog.